Perched high on a massive rock overlooking the city of Athens stands a landmark of Western civilization. The Acropolis. Here, 2,400 years ago, the Greeks built an extraordinary complex of temples where they could worship their gods. Now, as restorers dismantle and rebuild it, the Acropolis is revealing its hidden secrets. New clues are emerging from the restoration of its two largest buildings, the world-famous Parthenon and the imposing entrance gateway known as the Propylaea. The Parthenon was the greatest temple of its age. A wonder of the ancient world. From 22,000 tons of precious marble, Greek stonemasons assembled a building of exquisite perfection. Its 13,000 individual stones fitted together so precisely, the joints were watertight. Its 58 towering columns could withstand earthquakes. It's an extraordinary structure. But how exactly did the ancient Greeks construct it? The secret to the Parthenon's perfection begins with its special building material, marble. Its largest blocks are massive, weighing in at 10 tons each. But no marble existed in Athens. So how did the ancient Greeks find and transport these enormous pieces of marble to this dizzying hilltop site? The answer lies at Mount Pentelikon, 17 kilometers from the city. Historian Edith Hall has come here to piece together this ancient mystery.
This is the very birthplace of the Parthenon. These great rock faces where they cut down the marble and took it all the way to Athens to build the Acropolis. And everywhere you look, there's just glittering white marble, just stones of every size. I mean, look at this one. Just pick it up off the floor. You can actually see how incredibly gleaming white it is. And there's sparkly bits that you can see once it's polished up and smoothed down and chiseled, it would actually gleam in the sunshine. It's actually incandescent.
Although Edith is surrounded by marble at the ancient quarry, most of it is in small pieces. In ancient times, craftsmen would have struggled to find the enormous blocks needed to build the Parthenon. Today, workers at this modern quarry on Mount Pentelikon face the same challenge. The blocks from here are considered special.
They're highly prized because of their quality, their whiteness.
They are from the same seam of marble as the ancient quarry and are used for the Acropolis restoration.
It's exactly the same marble the ancients used to make the constructions and in Parthenon. It's not exactly the same place as the ancient did, but it's exactly the same marble.
Even with modern machinery, extracting large blocks is difficult. The rock is full of natural fissures, tiny cracks that cause the marble to break. Diamond-coated wire saws slice through the stone with ease. But once Sotiris extracts the blocks, they often break up into smaller pieces.
Big blocks are needed for Parthenon. One, two, maybe three marble blocks of the appropriate size and strength can be found every year.
For the ancient Greeks, who only had hand tools, it would have taken years to extract all the large 10-ton stones needed to build the Parthenon. And once they had found their stones, they faced an even greater challenge. How did they transport these enormously heavy, precious blocks, 17 kilometers, then raise them to the worksite at the top of the hill? At the ancient quarry, Edith thinks she has found a clue.
Where I'm standing now is actually the road that was made to transport all those slabs from the quarry all the way downhill to Athens and to the Acropolis itself. It's downhill all the way. It's quite a steep gradient, but it's regular and smooth, and the road's as straight as they could possibly make it so that the journey was as short as possible, because it was an incredibly hard labour for all of them.
On the Acropolis, the Athenians felt closer to their gods in the sky. Although they worshipped many gods, the main temples on this site were dedicated to just one. Athena.
Athena was one of the oldest Greek gods. She's the goddess of cities, of civilization, and she's very, very often found worshipped where there's a high, rocky citadel where people tended to form big urban communities. That's why the city is called Athens. It's the city of Athena.
Athena was known as the Virgin Goddess, and so the people named this building, from the Greek word for virgin, the Parthenon. Historical accounts reveal this once was a shining temple. Inside, an 11-meter tall statue of the goddess Athena. In her hand, a human-sized figure of Nike, the goddess of victory. Around her rises an exquisite building, created so the people of Athens could properly worship the goddess they believed would protect their city and make it impregnable. Recently, archaeologists here have made an amazing discovery.
Ah, it's something very rare.
The remains of a strange structure lie hidden beneath the Parthenon. Could it be that the building we see today is not the original?